Hello and welcome back to today's lecture on location of partition values on graph. In this video, we are going to discuss about how we are going to read the partition values on a graph. So in this video, we are going to discuss the meaning of graph, the process of locating partition values on graph, and problems on locating these values graphically. So as you know, a graph is a visual form of presentation of data. We prepare a graph on a special type of paper, which is known as a graph paper. It is nothing but a paper which is subdivided into small parts. And by using that graph paper, we are going to plot the graph. And after plotting the graph, we are going to read the partition values, or we are going to find out the partition values. We are going to locate the partition values. So partition values can be located graphically by preparing any one of the ogive curves or cumulative frequency curves, either less than or more than. The following steps should be followed. First step is ascertain the cumulative frequency, either less than or more than. Plot the values on x-axis and y-axis respectively. Draw the ogive curve. Then find the n divided by 4 for quartile, n divided by 10 for decile, and n divided by 100 for percentile. So after calculating these values, n divided by 4, n divided by 10, and n divided by 100, we have to draw a line parallel to the base, cutting the ogive at any point, and then we need to draw a line perpendicular to the base, and the partition values are read off. It can be better understood with the example. So here is an example problem. Determine graphically the value of Q2, D3 and P35 for the data given below. So here is the continuous series given. The class intervals are given from 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, similarly up to 40 to 45, and the respective frequencies are given. So for locating these quartile, decile and percentile values on the graph, we first need to calculate the cumulative frequency. So for this, we are going to take the less than cumulative frequency. We need to plot the class intervals in the first column. Then we need to plot the frequency values in the second column. Then we can easily calculate the less than cumulative frequency. That is, for first class interval, the frequency is going to be 8. For the second class interval, the frequency is 8 plus 14, which is equal to 22. For third class interval, it is 8 plus 14 plus 8, which is equal to 30. For the next class interval, it is 8 plus 14 plus 8 plus 25, which is equal to 55. Similarly, we are going to calculate the cumulative frequency, and our total or n value is equal to 90. So after calculating the cumulative frequency, we need to prepare the graph by plotting the values like this. We are going to prepare the graph OX axis. On OX axis, we are going to plot the class intervals. On OY axis, we are going to plot the cumulative frequency. So here, for plotting these values, we need to see what is the class interval. The class interval is 5, equal to 5. So starting from 0 to 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, up to the highest class interval, that is 45. So here you can see we have taken the on OX axis, we have taken the class interval, and the width is 5. That's why we have taken the difference of 5. And starting from the lowest class interval to the highest class interval, we have plotted the values on OX axis. Similarly, we have to see the cumulative frequency. The frequency starts from A and goes up to 90. So we can take the difference of 10 and up to, we can go 90. We can go up to 90. By taking the difference of 10, we can go up to the 90, because our highest frequency is 90. So after plotting OX axis and OY axis values, we need to plot the cumulative frequencies, and we need to prepare the less than ogive curve. So for the first class interval, that is from 10 to 15, the cumulative frequency is 8. So for 10 to 15 value, up to 15, we can take the cumulative frequency as 8. For 15 to 20, the frequency is 22. We have to plot it here. For 20, it is 22. Similarly, for 25, the frequency is 30. For For 30 to 25 to 30, the frequency is 55, and so on and so forth. For up to the last class interval, the frequency is going to be up to 90. So after plotting this ogive curve, our next step is calculating the n divided by 4. So in this problem, we are calculating Q2, D3 and P35. So for Q2, we need to multiply n with 2 and divide it with 4 because it is a quartile. So 2 into n divided by 4, maadidre namga 2 into n is already given here, 90. So 2 into 90 divided by 4, which is going to be 180 divided by 4. It is going to be equal to 45. So after finding out this 45, we have to locate the 45 on the cumulative frequency column. Okay, so 45 lies here, 40 and 50. So 45 is here, exactly in between 40 and 50. We have to draw a line parallel to the base. We have to draw a line up to this ogive curve. So ellivarigu aa ogive curve ge touch aagtati allivarigu on line draw maadbeku, then elli touch aagtati allinda exactly one vertical line now kelage draw maadbeku. So ast maadidre namaga Q2 29 value ille bartati. So 25 to 30 ide. So if you draw this map or draw this graph exactly on the graph paper, you will come to know exactly the 29 value here. So our Q2 is equal to 29. And then for similarly D3 value, we need to calculate 3 into n divided by 10. We are calculating D3, that is why we need to multiply n with 3. And we are calculating decile value, that's why we need to divide it with 10. So now ast maadidre namge baro value 27 ide. So 27 now graph mele read maadbeku ille ox axis oy axis mele where we have plotted the cumulative frequencies. So 29 is here. We need to draw a line parallel to the base up to the ogive curve. Then you need to draw the vertical line. So ille kelag baro value namda D3 value agirtati, which is equal to 23.5. So for the third one, that is percentile P35, we need to multiply n with 35 and divide it with 100. Then our value is 31.5. We need to plot that 31.5 here, and we need to draw a line parallel to the base and up to the ogive curve. And from that, we need to draw a line vertical to the base, and we will come to know the P35 value, which is equal to 26. So this is how we calculate or we locate the partition values graphically. Thank you so much for listening patiently.